Hello sir, I am Aditya Laxmi Sharma of class 9. Today I am going to present a presentation on my topic Heron's formula. So here I begin. So here is my introduction portion. We have already studied in the earlier classes about the area of triangles. We know that area of triangles is half into base into height. So here I'll explain area of triangle in terms of Heron's formula. So, this formula can be used only when we have the values of base and height given. And the formula is A is equals to under root S minus A, S minus B and S minus C, where A is the area of triangle, S is semi-perimeter and ABC are the side of triangles. So, moving on to the next slide, we have discovery of Heron's formula. So, Heron's formula was discovered by Heron of Alexandria, also known as Hero of Alexandria, who was a Greek engineer and mathematician. Heron's formula is used to calculate the area of triangle using the length of its three sides. According to Heron and his formula, we have determined the area of any triangle, be it scalene, equilateral or isosceles, with the help of formula as long as we have the length of all three sides provided. There are mainly four types of triangles: equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle, right angle triangle and scalene triangle. Heron was born in about 10 AD, possibly in Alexandria in Egypt. His work on mathematical and physical subjects are so numerous and varied that he is considered to be encyclopedic writer in this field. His geometrical works deal largely with the problems on mensuration. He has derived the famous formula for the area of triangle in terms of its three sides. So in our next slide, we have area of isosceles triangle. To explain this portion, I have mentioned one problem here. We have to find out area of isosceles triangle. So to solve this, we have to first find height by using Pythagoras theorem, since we have two equal side and one unequal side. After finding height, we can easily find out area by using half into base into height. Next thing, we have the area of equilateral triangle. Here also we have to find out area when side is given. Here also we will use Pythagoras theorem to find height. After finding height, we can easily find out area by using half into base into height. Moving on to our second last topic, we have area